welcome back to my channel. On this episode, I'm going to be covering mastitis, blocked milk ducts, milk blebs, my experiences with them, how to unblock them, how to avoid getting them, basically all things ducts, etc. My first experience with it, oh God, I remember it, and it was awful, like literally so tragic. So I remember sitting there and thinking, oh, that feels like a really hard lump. The only way I can describe it is like an implant. I don't have boob implants, but it looked and felt like an implant on the top. And it was just getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And it was sending me into a panic because obviously as I'm pumping, one boob's absolutely fine. You know, that's getting the normal amount. And then the other boob was getting hardly anything. That's how I knew that it was blocked and you could see it. It wasn't at that stage of like getting red and burning yet. So I hadn't turned to mastitis. I knew that it was a blocked milk duct. And anyway, so I called my midwife, and this was the very first time, and she came over and she helped me unblock it. Now, I'm not joking, we were there for 2.5 hours while she hand expressed my boob, and we were using warm and cold compresses, which I'm gonna get onto. We were using this bullet for vibrations to get from obviously the top of the blocked duct to the nipple to unblock it. We were doing all sorts, honestly, and obviously she was trained in it. She was a midwife, so I think she also had done what they call the lactation specialists. She'd done that as well, and she got it. She unblocked it, and she showed me the stream that when she unblocked it, this is what happened, and obviously had to keep going to get rid of it. But the second time it happened, and I was by myself. And I remember messaging her, and she was at work, so she was talking me through it, and I was thinking, oh my God, I'm never gonna get this out. Like, this is gonna be the end of my pumping journey. I got really upset about it, to be honest, and you know, you end up crying a lot about it, and I used to get a lot of anxiety over feeding anyway, because I didn't know how much he was getting. Anyway, so I just started, I like kind of spoke to myself in the mirror. I was like, right, okay, you can do this, you can get rid of this blocked duct. Okay, if you got rid of it before, you can get rid of it now. I'd already started taking those tablets that I told you guys to get in my previous story, I'm used to talking on Instagram, in my previous clip, the sunflower lecithin. But basically, I'd go through the motions of the oceans with these. So I would heat up these kind of heat pads for like 20 seconds, I'd put them on, and then I would massage around the area where it's blocked and I would hand express. Now, one thing that you could do is go on all fours to hand express. It really, really helps. So I kind of went through this sort of cycle. I'd start off with a warm compress, I'd then hand express. It would be so painful and sore. Some people actually take ibuprofen and paracetamol before they start the hand expressing because it can leave you with bruises because you have to go that hard. I would then, after hand expressing, try the pump again. If nothing was coming out and it was still blocked, I'd then run a really, really hot bath, and I'd put, a lot of people use Epsom salts, but I didn't have Epsom salts at the time, so I used this British, literally, table salt, and I put so much salt in there. I remember the first bath that I did, I didn't put enough salt in there at all, like, it just didn't help, but then I filled the bath with quite a bit of salt, let it dissolve, and I'd get in the bath, and I'd be, like, on all fours, and I'd dip my boob into it, and I'd hand express, and I could start to see, obviously, milk coming out, and it was starting to get them. Then I'd use this again, the bullet go to the top, to the nipple, just keep pressing on it, and then hand expressing again. It's kind of really repetitive, but you have to do it in order to get the blocked gone. Sometimes you'll end up with like a white spot or something like that on the end of your nipple or around the edges of your nipple. I actually didn't know that they were called milk blebs at the time, but for some reason, my brain was like, look, just pop it like a spot and just be careful in the bath. So obviously the salt water was in there, so it would have just got rid of any bacteria, etc., and it would have cleansed it out. So as I was dipping it, I did pop the little milk bleb. And then as I did that, I heard a pop. This is my first time unblocking it myself. And then I could continue to hand express. And then literally it started draining, like this continual stream of milk. And then you'd keep hand expressing or shove the pump on after the bath to just drain out all the blockage. That's important as well. So that was my first, you know, really horrendous one. The other one I had was for 12 hours. I'm not joking. I woke up 6 a.m. and I could feel a small lump. Not as big as the time before, but I knew if I left it, it would just get worse and worse and worse and worse. So I started the process all over again. And it was just super hard to get this out because in the time, obviously the 12 hours, I'm having to pump to get milk to feed my baby as well. But I just had to keep going with the steps. And I'm not going to lie, that time really didn't nearly finish me off. But I just kept going. And the hot water, the baths. I even got in the shower before and used the head of the shower and used that as a massager on my breasts. That's helped. What other things have I done to help? Oh, yeah. So, you know when you're pregnant and they tell you that you can't lie on your front? Well, you can't lie on your front when you're pumping, that is for sure, because that can block your ducts up as well. And lying on the side. So I tend to just lie on my back just to avoid it. Obviously, because it was so painful, I didn't want to risk getting another one. Another thing, if you're breastfeeding, they say to put your baby onto your breast to breastfeed. That will help unblock the duct. And they say to direct the chin at where the block actually is. But obviously, I wasn't breastfeeding, so I was pumping. And of course, I couldn't really do that with the pump because pump doesn't have a chin, so I just had to do it as best I could. Another thing that helps is pumping on all fours. I think it's the gravity, but I try to massage and use the heat compress at the same time. So obviously I normally use a double pump, but if there was just one boob that was blocked, I'd just use the one pump, and with the other hand, I'd use the heat compress and then massage it down. All I can honestly say is persevere. Just keep going, because I've had a lot of women message me on Instagram about it, and I'll talk them through it and they'll go, oh, okay, I think I've unblocked it. And then I'll go, okay, perfect. Does it feel like breast tissue now? Now it's unblocked, does it feel like your normal boob? And they'll go, no, it's still a little bit hard. And I'm like, it's not gone completely. You might have only got rid of one of the blocked ducts and there might have been a couple. So keep going, do the whole process all over again, because otherwise you're gonna find yourself at the very beginning. And she did, and then she did unblock it. So she was like super thrilled that she managed to do that, because she was in a lot of pain. Thing is, if you leave blocked ducts long enough, they then obviously get infected and it turns to mastitis, and mastitis is super, super painful. Luckily, I didn't get to that stage. I thought I had, but I didn't. I managed to catch it before it turned nasty. But you have to go on antibiotics and it can get really red and hot. So yeah, I'd recommend definitely trying to be in tune with your boobs. It sounds a bit weird, but you know, give them a feel after feeding each time, or after you get out of the shower or bath, give them a little massage, and you know, take care of them, because they are like your feeding babies, you know. I know we feel like cows at this point and just always milking ourselves, but you know, it's what we do for our babies. I'm just trying to think, yeah, you just got to persevere and just treat them really, really like kindly. Treat your breasts kindly. And if you feel any lumps, then that's when to get on it. You know, if you get on it early enough, then it's easier to unblock. Sometimes you can unblock. I think I've unblocked a duct within 20 minutes before, because I caught it early. It's those night ones and missing your pump session, or you know, sleeping through an alarm for a pump session, not draining your boobs enough, i.e. your pump setting not being on a high enough setting to drain your boobs. If it's on a low setting, that's not fully drawing out the milk, that can cause blocked ducts. There are lots of reasons why you can get blocked ducts. So it's just super important for anything that you do with your boobs or pumping routine or anything, just to go slow with it, because anything you change can really, really affect your body. Obviously, dropping pumps, for example, and you know, switching the times of your pumps if you want a different schedule, can really affect your boobs. So just go with it slow and keep the consistency for a few days before you then make another change, because that's what I learned, and I learned it the hard way. So the times I've found myself getting blocked milk ducts will be when I've slept through an alarm in the middle of the night because I was so, so exhausted. I mean, I think I started to do, say I had to be up at 2 a.m, I started to do a 2 a.m. alarm, a 2:05 alarm, a 2:10 alarm, just so it would keep going off so I wouldn't sleep through it. And when I did do that, little one's just piping up now. It's gone quiet again. He's started to learn how to scream, so I've got that to contend with. But yeah, so basically just missing those alarms for pumps it's just really hard. So that's when I found myself getting blocked milk ducts. No fun. So I think I've covered everything on blocked milk ducts, etc., how to avoid them, how to get rid of them. I've also put it on my Instagram page. It's in one of my grid posts. I think I'm standing in a mirror holding my baby, and it's like a little boomerang. So I do pop it on my story often, but hopefully this video has managed to help you guys as well. A lot of people, by the way, another thing, just a little tip. Hello, little one. Instead of a bullet, to use an electric toothbrush. Some people use the back of the head and they use it to go down. So I think I've pretty much covered everything. If you don't have a bath, maybe try a sink. Okay, so I'm going to do a question of the day where I've asked my followers on Instagram to give me a question and then I'll answer it on this video. So one of the questions is, Heidi, if it's not If it's not little junior, it's you. Can't get a break around here. Do you eat anything particular to help with your supply? I can't say that I eat anything in particular. I kind of just eat what I want. But I do try and drink as much as I can because that helps with your supply. So you've got to stay hydrated. I mean, I try and have one bottle that I drink throughout the day, and I'll have one bottle in the fridge ready to switch it up. So that's one of the things that I do. So yeah, I've answered that question. So any other questions, then just pop it onto my Instagram and I can do that in the next video. So if you liked this video, then click the like button and the notification bell. And if you can subscribe to my channel as well. And I hope to see you guys on the next video also. This is my Instagram. I'll see you guys soon. Take care.